Our first guest, Hal, do you have that data for us, that meteorological data? Hal, do you have that data? Damn it, Hal, can I have the data?
It's coming in. 71 degrees.
71 degrees. All right, toss it right up there so people can see it. Like, I don't know what difference that makes. There it is, 71. Relative humidity, Hal? Hal?
67%.
What did he say?
67%.
Don't make me come in there and fight you, Hal, okay?
Sylvester the cat.
What did he say?
He said it as...
What he says is 53%.
Okay.
67%.
All right, all right. See, this is what I'm talking about.
All right.
Our first guest will be at the Club Casino in New Hampshire on September 17th. He is a veteran. What? Okay. You want to do the whole segment back there? Okay, you're coming out. Just get ready. Wait a minute. Let me finish this. Our first guest will be at the Club Casino in New Hampshire on August 17th. He is a veteran actor and a very funny comedian and, ladies and gentlemen, a world-class skier. Please welcome Buddy Hackett. Here he is.
Thank you.
You look great. You look like you're terrific.
Yeah, I
haven't seen you in like 5 years, you here on the show.
I came to visit you one afternoon, if you recall.
Yeah, I do recall that, but
yeah,
you were on the show.
You were wearing sneakers.
I was what?
You were wearing sneakers.
That's right.
Yeah. Tennis shoes.
I'm wearing them again tonight.
Oh.
Yeah, there they are.
Same pair?
No. But anyway, you look terrific. It looks to me like you haven't gotten a day older. You must take good care of yourself.
I do. I do a lot of exercise.
Yeah? Do you actually ski?
Well, yeah, I'm some skier.
Are you really a good skier?
Yeah, my legs are as hard as this table.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I'll take your word for it.
You don't want to... You can feel them.
No, I don't want to feel them.
Everyone knows we're straight.
Well, that's right, but still and all, I'm not all that crazy about feeling your legs, if you don't mind. Anyway, so you live...
I'm not going to talk to you. Johnny always feels my legs. If I have a hot night, I get a kiss goodnight.
Is that right?
Oh, yeah.
Well, he spent too much time with Ed, I think, is the problem. Now, Buddy, it to me, you don't look like the guy who might be skiing for recreation or fun or even exercise. When did you start skiing and where do you do it now?
I live in Aspen, Colorado.
Mm-hmm.
And I started skiing at Grossinger's Hotel in 1945.
Mm-hmm.
I come out of the Army and I went up there to get a job. And I was taking care of the skate rentals and helping people lace on their mm-hmm. skates and take them on hikes. And there was a guy, Siegel Baum, and he said, you want to learn to ski? You would like to ski? You wish to ski? I said, listen, you Nazi. I just come out of World War II. I was in Aachen, Germany. Don't be telling me about Jew learn to ski. Jew learn to die.
Yeah, well.
So anyway, you know, then he just talked that way.
Yeah.
And
wasn't really a Nazi then, is what you're saying.
No, no.
Just
what?
Talked that way.
I knew that he really was a Nazi because I seen he had blintzes in his pocket. So anyway, I'm glad you give me a plug for that Club Casino because every 2 years I work there.
Uh-huh. And nice place, big resort area.
Well, it's a beautiful beach, Hampton Beach, New Hampshire.
Uh-huh.
And old young people, that's why I come on here to plug it, because it's got old youngsters like you got. Uh-huh. It's not oldsters. You know how old I am?
No, how old are you?
66.
Wow.
Yeah, sure. I have a card. If you show this card in the subway, they give you a ticket to come back free.
Really?
Yeah. But they can't guarantee that you'll live down there.
You know, you really don't look 66.
Well, I'm not 66 yet. I got another 9 days.
Oh, well, that would be the difference,
yes,
yeah.
That's right.
That's what threw me off.
So you got a keen eye. Anyway, I have some good jokes to tell you if you want to, if you could talk some more. We're not doing so bad just this way.
What do you want to do? You want to tell jokes?
I like to tell
All right, just
them.
Tell some jokes. Go ahead. You pick the topic and then tell the joke. Announce the topic, do the joke.
Announce what topic?
Of the topic of the joke. And now a joke about...
Well, most of the time I don't call it a joke. I call it a story. This way you're covered in case it don't go over. Right. It's only a story.
Yeah. The pressure is not there.
One of the smart things to do.
All right, tell us a story.
Well, this guy is in a doctor's office and he's getting he's getting examined, see?
Yeah.
2-hour examination.
Wow.
Doctor says to him, I have to talk to your wife. He says, she's in the waiting room. She's been there 2 hours. No, he says, I told her it'd be a while. She must have come in 10, 15 minutes ago. He goes out, the doctor says to the wife, listen, that husband's a workaholic. He works too much. I talked to him. There's nothing. I can't help him. You could help him. This man needs 3 home-cooked meals a day. I know you can't do that, but you could get up a half hour, 45 minutes early, make him a nice breakfast. Have his dinner waiting when he comes home. Once in a while, you pack him a little something to take with him so he don't eat crap. He's eating crap. Now, so that'll take care of the physiological, but the psychological... Relieve the pressure. Get the pressure. You got to make sure he has sex with you 3-4 times a week. Wow. And even he don't want to, lure him, torment him, little cleaveroo,
yeah.
And get him into that bed for sex. 3-4 times a week. You got it? 3 home-cooked meals a day, sex 3-4 times a week. She says, thank you. They go home, and the husband said, what'd the doctor say? She says, you're going to die.
Nothing we can do for you. I can recall, it seemed like a couple of years ago, you said you were going to take it easy and maybe even slow things down and not work as much. But here, you're working all the time now.
No, just these 3 nights. The last time I worked was Atlantic City, 4th of July week.
Uh-huh.
And before that, 3-4 months or something.
You just go out when you feel like doing something fun.
It depends when my manager calls.
Right.
And if he catches me right, like if he would catch me after I empty this cup, I'll work Mars.
Well, yeah. It's a little rocket fuel then, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Do you remember the first time when you started doing clubs and stuff?
Yeah.
Did you always have off color material? Is that the stuff you started with?
No.
Do you remember the first time you told like a dirty joke or what then would be considered?
Yeah, but. In the beginning, I was spotless. I didn't even say hell or damn on stage.
You probably couldn't in those days, right?
Well, in the beginning, but after a while, once you're filling a room, you say what you want.
Yeah.
You park your car on a lawn, you do whatever you want. But the minute you stop doing business, they sell the car or they burn it with you in it.
Yeah.
I work for some rough people. So anyway, I work them for Boozy in Chicago, and I tell him a joke. He says, tell that out there on the floor. So I said, I can't tell her. He says, it's not a suggestion.
Oh. Now, what year are we talking about?
61.
61, okay.
So the first joke I told... Oh, you don't get nervous like John. He gets so nervous when I'm going to... Well, the first one I said, I was in the Army, and we had a colonel named Fat Ass Johnson. Are you allowed to say that? I mean, nobody called him that. They called him Colonel Johnson, sir. But when you come home from a 10-mile hike and you got blisters, you're going to, Fat Ass Johnson. Now I'm working a motor pool, you know, where they keep all the cars in it?
Uh-huh.
And I'm cleaning something, and the phone rings, and it says, recruits, do not answer phone.
Right.
I had to have something from home. Hello, and the voice says, soldier, what vehicles have we got available? I said, 6 trucks, 7 Jeeps, an M8 armored car, a half track, and Fat Ass Johnson's command car. And the guy says, soldier, have you any idea who you're talking to? I said, no. He said, this is Colonel Johnson. I said, oh, Colonel, have you any idea who you're talking to? He said, no. I said, bye-bye, fat ass.
Sure.
Now, he wrote in the paper... You're going to laugh. You want to hear history.
Yeah, no, let's hear a little history then.
So now they wrote in the paper that I do ass jokes. But they didn't say 3
they,
letter.
They write this
no,
in the
no,
paper?
3 letter. Earl Wilson made a crusade.
Yeah.
You know, I don't think midgets should attack people. So, and then his son wrote a thing, The Dirtiest Show on Broadway. Did you know
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I do remember that. This is in the days of Old Calcutta and like that. And this
yeah,
was,
but that yeah, was much
know,
later.
Know,
but
yeah.
In the beginning, Earl got on me. So now I said... He does 3 three dashes were jokes.
You're labeled on the basis of that one joke.
Yeah, but that's not an ass joke. An ass joke is the blind guy crossing the street. You know that story?
No!
And he's not a dog.
No!
You want a tablet?
Yeah.
And he's got a dog, and he crosses the street, and a guy says to him, "Sir, that dog nearly got you killed. Cars were almost hitting you." He said, "Really?" And he took a dog biscuit out of his pocket. And the guy says, "You nearly got killed, that dog, and you're going to feed him?" He said, "No, I just want to find out where his head is so I can kick him in his ass."
That's more of a, that's your traditional ass joke.
Right.
Well,
another one. You want another one?
No, we gotta go here.
One more.
All right, one more.
And don't tell me you gotta go.
All right, well, here, yell at this guy.
I could stay a few days.
And then when you're done yelling at him, yell at that guy over there.
Dog, I'll fight him.
Yeah.
Okay, so this guy takes a girl in a cemetery to make love.
Right.
It's an old cemetery, a colonial cemetery, with a flat tombstone.
Yeah.
And on this flat tombstone, they indulge themselves. Uh-huh. Next day, she has a backache. He took her to the doctor. Doctor say, "Would you disrobe?" That's all right.
Disrobe.
She disrobed.
Yeah.
He's a doctor.
Yeah.
Yes. And she disrobed. He said, "Turn about." She turned about. He said, "How old are you?" She said, 28. Why? He says, "Says on your ass you died in 1784.